Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. My name's David, and today I'm going to be reviewing Renogy's first pro model lithium iron phosphate smart battery. If you're new to the channel, I've developed a simple solar guide that is perfect for beginners or anyone who's going to be installing a solar system for the first time in their RV, their camper van, their trailer, or any off-grid solar system. So be sure to check out the link below. It includes discount codes, part list, overview of all the components, and a ton of other information. And I've had a lot of positive feedback from everyone who has downloaded and used this guide, so be sure to check it out. For a while now, I've been asking myself why manufacturers of all these lithium iron phosphate batteries haven't included Bluetooth and self-heating into every battery. I might be a little bit biased because I don't live somewhere warm and cozy. I live in the northern cold climate like many of you, and I need a heated lithium battery. When it comes down to it, the cost is worth the peace of mind. This 100 amp hour battery has a price tag at $800, but Renogy always has a ton of discounts going on, and be sure to use the discount code made to travel when you go to check out. If you're purchasing anything from Renogy, you'll get an extra discount. This pro model that Renogy has come out with doesn't just include Bluetooth and self-heating capabilities. It is also an extremely safe battery. What I mean by that is this battery is fire retardant. It is waterproof and dust resistant with an IP67 rating, and it is also corrosive resistant. This is the battery itself, classic Renogy sleek matte black design. It's got a nice chamfer kind of going around the top here, adds a little bit to the design, but again, it's pretty compact, especially for a 100 amp hour battery with Bluetooth and heating. And it only weighs 27 pounds, which is pretty light comparing to other batteries. It comes with extra bolts. There's two sizes of bolts that it ships with. These are the longer one and these are shorter ones here. It also comes with some decals from Renogy and the instruction manual. This battery has an upgraded heating system from Renogy's last battery, and it actually will heat the cells 20% faster. This battery also has a total of 5 temperature sensors, which is a lot compared to a lot of other batteries. Most of the time you see 1 or 2 sensors. 2 seems to be the standard minimum now. There seems to be kind of a low and a high temperature. Along with the upgraded heating system, this battery includes 5.0 Bluetooth with OTA. And what that means is over the air updates. Renogy can actually remotely update this battery from the app on your phone if any updates are required in the future, or if they have any issues that they want to fix with the BMS. The battery also has an upgraded BMS that includes active backup protection. This increases the speed at which the BMS can react. A lot of other batteries, slow reaction time, but with this backup one, if it senses a low temperature, if it senses a high temperature, or if it senses low voltage or high voltage, whatever triggers that BMS, it'll shut the battery right down to protect those cells. This battery has the highest cycle life when it comes to Renogy's other 100 amp hour batteries. This one is good for 5,000 cycles at 80% DOD. I'm always telling people to look at the cycle life when it comes to a battery, because that can really vary from battery to battery and it reflects on the price, and you want a battery that's going to last a long time. 5,000 cycles, pretty good. This battery can be charged at a max of 100 amp and it has a max continuous discharge of 100 amps, but it has a max surge discharge of 245 amps for 30 seconds, which is enough power to get your AC going or other electrical components that suck a lot of power at startup. You can connect this battery with up to 8 other batteries in parallel for a maximum of 800 amp hours. This battery cannot be connected in series. If you want to connect Renogy batteries in series, I would recommend checking out their core lineup. I have a review video about the 200 amp hour core series, which is also a great battery. Another pretty cool feature that they've done with this battery is they've actually installed screw holes on the bottom here for mounting brackets that are sold separately. I think they should be probably included with the battery because I think most people will use them when installing. I know a lot of people that just use bungee cords or ratchet straps to secure their batteries down in place, but being able to screw it down into plywood or the floor of your RV or trailer would be very convenient. The battery comes with a 7-year warranty, which is also the highest compared to Renogy's other 100 amp hour lithium iron phosphate batteries, which I believe are 2 years and 5 years. So again, this one's going to be the most expensive, obviously, but it is backed by not only better features, but a better warranty. First negative about this battery is the fact that you can't connect it in series, which is unfortunate. The second one is going to be size. These batteries are consistently getting smaller in size, and Renogy has done a good job at this 100 amp hour battery, but I wanted to show you guys, compare it to a couple other batteries that I have here, and just so you can see for yourself. So this is Renogy's self-heating previous battery, which is honestly identical almost in size. So it is just a little bit longer and a little bit narrower, but this one is obviously a little bit higher. And I'm sure if you guys are in the market for a 100 amp hour battery, you've probably heard of the mini batteries out there. And I actually have one here just so you can compare size. This is LiFePO4 100 amp hour mini. And to be honest, it's not that mini when compared to the Renogy 100 amp hour battery. Remember, with heating and Bluetooth. Lengthwise, it's like a quarter inch smaller probably, but it is 3/4 inch higher. And then this is gonna be the big difference here. It's probably 2 inches thinner than the Renogy one. Honestly, these mini batteries have way less features and they're not that much smaller. So if you're thinking size is gonna be a big component, Renogy's battery is still pretty small. The only downside to this battery is the fact that it can't be connected in series. Kaylee and I are headed to Banff and Lake Louise this weekend for a winter ski getaway, and I'm just packing up the van, getting all of our skis and stuff in here. And I thought this was the perfect opportunity to test out this new Renogy 100 amp hour Pro battery. I've hooked it up here and I just want to do a few tests and show you guys the install. It's obviously very straightforward, positive to positive, negative to negative. I'm gonna go ahead and charge it up at about 60 amp with the Renogy inverter, and then I'm going to do a load test just to make sure everything is operating as it should. It's not too cold today, it's around zero. I think the battery should be just fine. If it was minus 20, this would be a really good test for it, but it's not that cold, unfortunately. A negative terminal right here goes to my shunt, which is right there. And then I have the positive right here, just going to my main switch here. So I've already turned it to on, and I think the battery is sitting just above like 13 volts or something. So let's go ahead and turn on the inverter and see how this thing charges up. We're charging up at about 60 amp, which is quite a bit. This battery can receive up to 100 amp hours. So, I mean, we're just over 50%, but I can't imagine a lot of people will be charging a battery at 100 amp. I have a space heater plugged in here that draws a ton of power. So let's go ahead and turn this guy on and see how the battery functions. So that space heater is pulling almost 170 amp hours, which is well over of what the battery's continuous discharge is rated at. Oh, and it just quit. So the BMS is working correctly. Turned it down to the first setting for the space heater, and it's drawing about 76 amp hours, which is just under the 100 amp hour continuous discharge. That was a good test to show that the BMS is working correctly though, because sometimes that doesn't actually cut out and it'll just continue to draw on some of the cheaper model batteries that I've tested in the past. Load test and the charging test on this battery went over really well. The BMS seems to be functioning as it should. I'll do some more tests this weekend once we're out in the mountains and the temperature drops a little further to make sure that everything's working correctly. This battery is going to be perfect for anyone who has an off-grid setup that they keep going all winter long. It'll be great for people who do a lot of winter camping, and especially perfect for people who do any ice fishing. I do a lot of fishing in the summertime, fly fishing, but I don't do a lot of ice fishing, but I'd imagine this would be absolutely perfect for those people. If you use batteries in colder climates, anything really below 0 degrees Celsius, which that's a lot of North America, I would definitely recommend getting this battery. If you have a camper van or an RV, I would recommend getting multiple ones because 100 amp hours is a little bit on the smaller side. I would recommend at least 200 amp hours if you can. If you want to check out any of the components that I use here in my setup, I will link them down in the description, so be sure to check those out. If you guys found this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions for me, be sure to leave them in the comments below. I'd love to hear what you think of this battery, and I'll see you guys in the next one.